Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel. This is Frank in Action, and welcome to our new episode here at Let's Learn with Frank. Let's split the brain as we were called from our study of human anatomy. We can divide the brain into two cerebral hemispheres. We call this the left brain and the right brain, and they are entirely separate structures apart from the cerebral commissioners that connect her. These hemispheres are not the same, and certain brain functions are localized largely in one hemisphere versus the other. This does not support the myth of the left brain or the right brain individuals, as was debunked in this fun tutorial in case you are interested in pop psychology. But there remains much to be said about brain lateralization, including the shocking realization that the two hemispheres can function independently and have almost completely separate identities. So let's get a closer look at the split brain. Now, much of our understanding of the split brain came about due to the experiments in the 1950s, where the cerebral hemispheres were isolated from one another by severing the corpus callosum, which is the largest cerebral commission, with around 200 million axons connecting the two hemispheres. This was done for medical reasons, with patients suffering from severe epilepsy. What was quite surprising in all cases is that subject behaves rather normally after this major procedure. Each hemisphere operates independently and no major function is lost. However, the hemispheres are unable to communicate with each other, so it is no longer possible for one hemisphere to know something that the other hemisphere has learned. So the easiest way to test this is to feed different visual information to each hemisphere of the brain. This is quite simple. Given the way information travels from the eyes to the visual cortex, the left eye sends input to both hemispheres, but the right visual hemifield of the left eye goes to the left hemisphere, while the left hemifield goes to the right atmosphere. And precisely, the same goes to the right eye. So by selectively showing the images to one eye and not the other, it is a wide variety of data and can be gathered, so meaning the speech is localized in the left brain. So when showing a patient an image and asking them what they see, their verbal response will depend on whether the image is being shown to the left brain or the right brain. Sometimes when information is given to both sides of the brain, the left brain may respond verbally while the right brain responds some other way, like pointing to a word or touching something. The two answers will completely opposing or otherwise incompatible. This and many other experiments seem to suggest that there are completely separate streams of consciousness going on in the two hemispheres, each maintaining its own sense of self at times when displaying different beliefs and personalities. Now, let's get more specific about the rules of each hemisphere. To be clear, nothing is totally completely lateralized. It is only that one hemisphere is favored over the other in controlling certain functions. For example, regarding vision, the left hemisphere is better at recognizing words and letters, while the right is better at recognizing faces, emotions, and geometrical functions or patterns. The left is better at interpreting spoken language, while the right is better at analyzing other types of sounds like music. The left is better at processing verbal memory and finding meaning in memories, while the right is better at processing nonverbal memory and recalling perceptual aspects of memories, while the left is better for speech, reading, writing, and arithmetic, while the right is better for spatial reasoning, rotating objects in the mind, and discerning direction or distance. As we said, this is not to be exaggerated. Many of these actions involve multiple cognitive activities and thus can't be limited exclusively to one hemisphere. Furthermore, some people have specialization of the hand as spheres reversed so that language is on the right. And interestingly enough, these people are typically left-handed. As to why lateralization exists, some studies focus on anatomical differences between the hemispheres, such as differences in size between the areas of the cortex in either hemisphere, which do indeed exist, but these have not been conclusive. So most attempts to explain lateralization are centered around the most highly lateralized of all brain functions, and that's language. So let's move forward to get a closer look of our questions about the world. So make sure to subscribe in my YouTube channel. This is Frank in Action again, and welcome to my Let's Learn with Frank episodes. See you guys in my next video. Have a great day. Bye-bye.